That's incredible. Got a thumbs up, and there's nobody showing who's been here. That's got to be a record. Hi, Aaron, Marie, Hannah, David. I'm not going to stay on long term. An hour tops, because there's football on and I want to watch that. Hello, Madeline. And I'm waiting for my delivery of my paper shredder, so I won't be here for long. What should we do first? You know what, Jamie? Have you sorted out any hours that you fancy giving a bash to yet? I'm going to be a bit tied up this evening. I'm going to say I'm not going to stop on here long. I'm just coming on to explain the rules. And then I'm going to be watching the football this evening. Yeah, just ping us a message then, Jamie, and I'll sort them out for you, mate. Not a problem at all. Right, so what we decided to do, just trying to sort of liven it up a bit and do a few different things with the channel. Hello, Louise, Will, Ian. Just trying to do a couple of other things. What's wrong with Ian's mic? Wrong? I don't know, I just had it on in the background, so I wasn't really paying much attention. But if you tell us what the problem was, I'll mention it to Ian. We were just trying to come up with a few things, obviously still coin related, something a little bit different, and have a bit of fun with it at the same time. So what we've come up with is, to begin with, between myself, Hannah, and Dragon Lord Steve, was to do a CJ battle on eBay, where we're given a £20 budget and we ask you guys to pick a 1 hour slot for each of us. That person then has to go on to eBay. They can only buy from the auctions ending within that 1 hour period. They're not allowed to use buy it now. And postage has to be included in their £20 budget. So they can't buy something for 20 quid that's got 3 quid postage. If they go over budget, it's an automatic £5 deduction of the total value at the end. So we then go on there, buy anything coin related. We're going to try for the first one. So it can be coins, it can be, you know, I don't know, a key ring, a necklace, anything that's coin related. Once all three of us have done that, we'll send them off to Ian. Ian will value each person's items. And the person that's got the highest value is declared the winner. And maybe I haven't really thought too much about what we'll do for a winner. But the idea was that then the three, all the items that are purchased, because it can be one item, it can be 10 items, then get put into a raffle so that people can then buy the raffle tickets for all of the items that have been bought. So the idea is that after the first one, it just becomes self-funding. And depending what we put the raffle ticket prices at, will then dictate what budget we have for the next one and going forward. So we can change it about a lot. I said I hadn't thought too much, so I'm just thinking on my feet here. Maybe the winner gets to choose the subject for the next eBay auction. again, it's got to be coin related. So maybe they'll pick, you know, a certain year that you've got to buy coins from. Anna's already declared she's going to be winning. So that's the base of the rules for it. And as I say, once we become, obviously after the first one, hopefully the raffle sells out and it becomes self-funding. And once we've got that going a bit better, we'll then invite some of the other CJs to come and join us as well at times. The CJs, when they're doing the buying on eBay, they have to be recording themselves, whether it's using their phone or whatever. They have to record themselves, so we will get the time that they're on. So, you know, there's absolutely no way of it being cheated. So we'll see all of that. People have suggested that we all have the same 1 hour slot, because it'd be funny if we were bidding each other up and that kind of thing. Again, that's something that maybe we'll do further down the line, but to keep it nice and simple for the first one, we're all going to have separate 1 hour slots. So yeah, that's the basis of it to begin with. Once we've got all of the prizes or items, we send them to Ian. We'll send all the videos into Ian. They'll get all put into one video, and you will get to see it released on the channel that way. How we're going to involve you in it is we want you guys to pick the hour slot that we get. So be sensible, you know. I don't want 3 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday or something. It's got to be sensible hours. So I think if we do, I don't know, say from 10 o'clock in the morning, Steve, you can't buy from yourself. But it would show, Hannah, this is the beauty of him recording it. It would show. And to be fair, some of Steve's prices are quite pricey anyway, so I'm not sure if he's looking for a bargain. He'll be going for himself anyway. So the whole idea is that you're recording it. So if you guys want to throw us some hours and some dates, you know, say Monday 11 a.m. or something, and once I've got three of those, I'll then do it at random and pick who gets allocated which slot. Matt will be in drag, but not until 10 o'clock. I think he's running a bit late. I had him down as booked in from 8 till 9, but he's running late, so it's going to be around about 10 o'clock. So if a couple of you, if you want to just fire us a couple of times, and a couple of days, I shall jot them down. The first three dates and times that I see, I will put them down. But Hannah, you can't give me a date and a time. So come on, there's 24 of you on there. Any CJ gives me a bribe, I'll put up an item and cancel. 12 midday, is that, Lorna? It's got to be. I'm not doing 12 midnight. So, yeah, I'll do Monday or Wednesday, 12 midday. Yeah, so come on then. I want two more. There's plenty of you in here. Any two more dates like that. Wednesday at 3 p.m, that's a cracker. One more. No, I was only joking. One or seven's good, Jamie. So just need a date to go with that. It certainly does, RJ. I agree with you there, mate. Friday 3, that'll do then. Oh, Jamie, are you talking about for your slot? Are you talking about, or were you talking about for this? Sorry, I've got three there anyway. Monday or Wednesday, 12 midday. Wednesday, 3 p.m. Friday, 3 p.m. So what I'll do is I'll do it randomly. I'll film it again, and I'll just put our names in a hat, pull them out, and that they'll get allocated a time and a date when they can do their eBay auctions. Hannah's got a really busy week ahead. So, all right, sorry, Jamie. Hannah's got a really busy week ahead this week, so we'll probably start it next week. The last one's a Friday. Yeah, no worries, Jamie. That's be brilliant. Yeah, so keep an eye on the channel. The videos will probably, I would imagine, the videos will go up before any of the prizes get valued by Ian, because obviously we can put them up straight away. And then, so you'll see what we're getting. You'll get to join in a bit of fun, and you'll be able to say who you think's got the best deals. I saw something similar was done with some of the other coin tubers, and they got it to go to a public vote as to who won. But I didn't want to do that because I didn't want it to be, one CJ might have a better following than another CJ. So they were obviously going to get more votes. So I thought the easiest way is if we send everything into it to Ian, which is going to go there anyway to go up for a raffle, and Ian can Ian can come up with a price for us for each person's package. Ian doesn't know this yet, so I've kind of done it above his head, and he doesn't know. But he's just going to give us a valuation for each of them. Can you participate, Jamie? It certainly will be it, to begin with, Jamie. I've just kept it with the three of us. The idea being that once we've done the first one, all the prizes then go up for auction and it becomes self-funding. Once we've become self-funding on it, as long as the raffles sell, then we'll be able to invite a few more CJs to come and join us for it. And we'll be able to sort of play about a bit with the ideas. Just being the first one, I just wanted to keep it to the first three, the three of us. But yeah, the idea is that once it becomes self-funding, then we can obviously increase the item, value that we've got to spend each time, and we'll be able to, invite more CJs to come and join us. I say it's only a bit of fun, just something a little bit different on the channel, still coin related, but hopefully it'll also show people where you can grab some bargains on eBay. So, it's kind of a bit of fun, but at the same time, hopefully be able to show what deals that there are out there. I'm just trying to find something at the moment. My lights really, I really must get my lights sorted this week. don't give away too many secrets. I've got no secrets at all. I'm terrible. I tell everybody. You'd like to work your way up to one of those, Jamie? Oh, where can we see it? There we go. No. That was what got sent to me today, which made me extremely happy. Very nice coin. When we talk about it, certainly is. When we talk, a lot of people talk about the community, and that kind of stuff. And I won't reveal too much about it. We were on Steve Fraser's stream the, I don't know, a week or two ago, and Steve had mentioned that the prices on Kew Gardens on eBay had come down quite a bit. So I said that I'd go and have a look because I've been considering buying one for a little while. I don't know, then a week or so after that, I got an email. I won't say who it was from, but it's somebody in this community. that had just asked, was I looking for a queue? And if so, what sort of prices had I found them for? And to be perfectly honest, when I first got the email, I assumed that they were also in the hunt for a queue. So they were asking me what sort of prices I'd seen them for. So I just fired it back. I can't, Jamie. I'd love to reveal how much I paid for it, but I can't. It's just not fair to the person that I've got it from. But I will tell you the story. So I fired it, you know, the email back, back to them and explained what I'd found, etc. They were going for around about £100 at the time. I then got an email back from the person saying, well, I've actually got two of them. One of them's a little bit beaten up, but I've sent it to Ian to get it checked over. And if you want it, it's yours. I'll get it sent on to you. And then they told me the price. and I think I told you, Lou, haven't I? And anybody would have been a fool to have turned down the price. Let's just put it that way. I think you can sit on eBay for 24 hours solid and you won't get a price anywhere near what I paid for it. So when you talk about this community, it is just, and I will give Louise a mention there. Some of you know that she found a 2019 Peter Rabbit, or her partner found a 2019 Peter Rabbit in a coin hunt at the weekend. She's actually sent that to me to send on to my brother's daughter, who's just got into coin collecting. So when you say about this community, it's an incredible community. And there are so many other stories like that. Actually, that brings me on to one more thing that I've got to say. And I'm going to forget what one it is now. For those of you that watch the morning streams, you'll know that Amy does an awful lot of work in the background for us. And she's not collecting the A to Z's, but there are one that she's actually after. And I'm sorry, I'm scrolling through all messages to try and find which one it was. I think I know what it is, but I don't want to say it in case I get the wrong one. But Amy wants an addle from the, you know, Loch Ness, from the A to Z. She doesn't care if it's a 2018 or 2019. She's just putting something together in a frame. So if anybody can spare, oh, there, Stevie, you're an absolute diamond, mate. Absolute diamond. If you don't mind, then if you send that just into Ian and put, you know, for attention of Amy, that would be incredible. There were two letters that she wanted, and I managed to scrounge one off of Louise earlier for her. So if you can do it as well, Steve, that would be brilliant. Because, she puts in an awful lot of work behind the scenes, and I would never have started streaming to begin with if it wasn't for Amy. So I really appreciate that. Brilliant. Thank you. I really do appreciate that. Maria, starting out in the coin world, would have a little of any. We'll keep an eye. Yeah, no, it's not a problem. That's all sorted now. That was the only other thing I wanted to ask people for. Evening, laughter. I'll just go through it again. We're trying to spice the channel up a little bit, obviously still keeping it coin related, but we're open to many, many ideas that people might have. I'm going to get a knock on the door in a minute with my paper shredder. we're open to any ideas. Things that were mentioned today were, and it's something we'll have to work on, was things like having like a bingo, but obviously calling it Coingo instead of bingo. So yeah, any other, I was just reading what Ian had put, but I don't know, so I'm not going to cover that. So any other ideas like that that you might have, whether it's, you know, you want to see competitions between CJs, or you want to see competitions that involve you lot, anything like that, you know, drop one of us a message. Nothing gets sort of pushed to one side and said, no, that's a terrible idea. You know, it's always something that we'll sit there and we'll try and work our way around and see if it's something that we can do. Yes, I did. Thank you, Jeff. Jeff gave us a link to the Gibraltar 50p's that were at a really good price. So I managed to get a couple of them myself. So if there's any ideas that you come up with, you know, that you think you'd like to see on here. Yeah, there's a lot of people looking forward to Martha. I threw down a challenge this morning, and I'll say it again now while everybody else is on in the evening. If one single donation, and bear with me before you all jump in on my back first, because there is a little way that you can work this out better. If there is one single donation of £250 to a mental health charity of my choosing, then I will wear drag to, I can't even believe this, on the 25th of January around our mint trip. So you've got, Martha's going to be doing it on stream, and I'll do it on our meet, our trip to the Royal Mint. So although I've said, and I shouldn't really be telling you ways that you can work that out, but ways you can do it is, if you all club together and do it together, and then the one single donation is made, that still counts. So Jamie, as I said this morning, if it's regards to mental health, you know, I'm more than happy to do it. you've sussed me out. So if it's anything to do with mental health, then I'm more than happy to make a fool of myself for an hour or two. So that's another challenge that I've thrown down this morning. So that's in, I'll leave that in Hannah's hands, Hannah and Lou, I think. So if you guys think that you can do it and you can get £250, you come back and tell me when you've got that, and I'll give you the charity to make the donation to. So there you go. That's another challenge that we've also thrown down. So there's loads of, you know, all silly little ideas like this. and as much as we're allowed, we will film as much of it as we can around the mint. There you go. Ian's even put it there for you. One second, I've just got to answer my door.
Yeah, it's a bit difficult one. Go ahead. All right, mate. Cheers. Thanks a lot.
Okay, right. So, yeah, so sorry about that. So there you go. Ian's put it up there. If people want to make a donation through the admin and they leave a message to say it's for Warren's charity, we would collate it and write a check for you, what you raise between now and then. No points or vouchers. Yeah, no, that's fair. Absolutely fair. No points or vouchers. So, yeah. So, obviously, I've set it at 250, but if you make more between then, it'll be even better. I know I had quite a long chat with Dean from my family the other day, and we were definitely keen to get something done for mental health. So I threw that down really a little bit without thinking too much this morning, but I'm more than happy to go with that. So yeah, that's your challenge this week. So many people are going to be tuning in to watch you later on, Martha. It's going to be good fun. I must admit, when you sent that picture this morning to WhatsApp, I was like, what on earth is that? It took me a minute or two to twig it. So, yeah, so any silly little thing, silly ideas that you've got, you know, like all of these. Ah, okay, Stephen, not a problem. I'm sure, you know, I'm sure somebody else will come up with, I think it was an L, was it? I'm sure somebody else will come through with one. Yeah, so if, you know, no matter else, I'm always for, you know, making a fool of myself. I don't mind doing that. Okay, Lorna, if you wouldn't mind sending it into Ian for attention of Amy, I'd really appreciate that. So I can't... oh, there we go. Well, there you go. I didn't even know that from Ian. So he's going to add 25% to the full amount raised and add it to the cheque if you hit the 250 by the 20th of January. There you go. So there's even more incentive to smash that. And I really, really appreciate that as well, Ian. That's brilliant. Really has quite shocked me, that. But this is what I'm saying about this community. And I have no doubts that you'll reach probably, excuse me, you'll probably reach 250 before Christmas. So I have no doubts about that. But yeah, so, you know, you've seen... Obviously, Coins and More, he's more than happy to make a fool of himself. I'm more than happy to do it. So if you've got any more crazy ideas that you'd like to see, let us know. Any competitions, anything silly, you know, fire them in. And we'll see what we can do with them. I did see the comment earlier on. I'm sure it was Angela. It was her idea this morning about some kind of a bingo. And I'm sure that's something that we can kind of work around. My first thoughts were, instead of bingo cards, we changed them, or instead of numbers, sorry, we changed them to the coins. So, you know, you've got your Stephen Hawkins and... you know, all your different coins. So instead of numbers, we've got them. We sell the cards as we would sell raffle tickets. But I don't know, that's just something, you know, that I'll try and get my head around over the next few days. So, yeah, all ideas are welcome. Where's Hannah? I saw her. You do realise me and Lou get to pick your attire. Well, that's all right, Hannah, because I haven't got any of it here. So I'm more than happy for that as well. Marie, well, that, you know, this is the idea, because a lot of the stuff will be going, you know, we'll be able to snip them into individual videos as well. So we'll be able to upload individual videos of them. Coins and More did one from from Saturday from Sunday morning, sorry. So it'd be brilliant. Let me just see where else we're going. Martha's got to go and get herself ready. Go to the charity shop and get some man clothes. I honestly don't care, Lou. Honestly, I have no option, no problems at all. Swap shop hour. Yeah, that's an idea, a swap shop hour. I mean, we have got the Facebook swap shop group, but I do like the idea of a swap shop hour. My first thing that I would worry there is I'm not too sure how openly people would want their addresses shared. And I think it might be a little bit unfair for us to all send it to Ian to pass on to other people. There's nothing that he would be getting through from that. But maybe it's something we can do with it. So let me just see. okay, from Ian, on a personal note, he's looking for someone to help Fran with her WordPress website. If anyone can help and understands WordPress, he would be extremely grateful, and you can contact him. So if there's anybody that would be able to do that, then please get in touch with Ian, because Fran does an awful lot of good work. So I'm just trying to catch up on some comments at the same time. Angela's got to go. Bye, Angela. Thank you for dropping by. A lovely long skirt and headscarf. That would suit me fine. What size feet am I? An 8 or a 9. I wasn't going to tell you there, but yeah, an 8 or a 9. Please don't let Amy know. Let it be. Amy has no idea, Lorna. She asked me if I had any, I think it was yesterday, and I'd said I'll have to have a look and see what I've got, but she's got no idea that I've asked you guys. I think the world of Amy, and I know a lot, the people from the day streams also do. So I thought I'd put it out to you guys to see it. I've put my heat in on as well. It is extremely cold. It's a great idea, Sean. It's difficult to manage. It have to go through us. Yeah, that's exactly what I mean. It's something. Give me a day or two to think about it. And maybe there is a way that we could work around it. I don't know. We'll see where we can go with that one. How about a section where you almost run a viewing party where the CJs show us some videos from their corn community this week? Best polls, best reactions, giveaway, bloopers, good calls. Yeah, that's not a bad idea, Lufter. That's something we can definitely do. Fran's Gruffalo Pebbles are... I think she should do a few more and get some of them on the site, because I'm sure they'd be a really big hit. People tend not to give it. Yeah, that's the only thing that would worry me with that. Sorry to change the subject. I'd love to do a live, but I've only got 78 subs. Is there any apps I can use to go live with? The way I understand it is anybody can go live. The 1,000 subs is just if you want to monetize the stuff. I'm sure somebody will probably correct me if I'm wrong, but that's the way I understand it. Swap shop's only worth it for higher value stuff. Addresses could be exchanged for... Yeah, no, it's not exchanging it live on screen. Some people just don't want their addresses to be exchanged. They like to keep them, keep their addresses private. I must have missed a message from Maria because it was Fran saying thank you very much. honestly, Fran, your pebbles are awesome. So I do think you need to do some more and get them on the site, even if it's just, rough off a set of them or something, because they always get really good reactions from people when we see them. That's right, Ian put up the shout out for your WordPress, and I've just echoed it. They are so coloured and detailed. You do live by changing your settings into desktop mode to get around it. Okay, that's above mine. Don't take part in the swap if your privacy is important. Again, you know, I say, just give me a couple of days to think about how we can run with that, Sean, because there might be a way that we can get around it. You know, if we get a trusted CJ that doesn't mind it being done via them, you know, then it's only one person that's holding all of the addresses or something. Maybe there is a way that we can get around it. But let's just have a couple of days to think about it and see what we say. There we go. Marie's echoed. Thank you for the donation, friend. Get them raffled on auction, friend. Yeah, I totally agree. Thank you. I only just started. Going to take a while till I get there watching your videos and other people, and it's helping a lot. That's brilliant. That's what it's all about, is helping everybody. You need to stop with CJ with a massive stop of duplicates, then the viewers are swapping with the CJ. Yeah. Another idea, live auctions where items are sent in and you have a seller and buyer fees. So almost like a live eBay, if you like, then I guess, is what you mean with that. Fran's going to be doing a Fran story, a bit like Jack and Nori, a bedtime story of the Gruffalo soon for everybody, for all you coin hunters who love the coin but don't yet know the story. Hope you can join us. I will certainly join because I don't know the Gruffalo story either. So I will certainly be joining in for that. So yeah, I'm just going to stick with you till 8 o'clock. I said I was only going to pop on for a little bit. I've got some football that I need to watch tonight. But don't forget, it's an absolute must to tune in at 10 o'clock. None of you want to miss what you're going to see at 10 o'clock. Fran, going to go get my blankie and nick some of Ian's whiskey. Lost count of the amount of times I've read it to my kids. Probably, you know. See, I haven't got a clue what the story is. Fran, get the Gruffalo's Trail 2 as a follow-up. I've actually got a Gruffalo Trail. I know Fran went on one recently, and she left some of her painted stones on there with little notes underneath to send them in if anybody finds them. And it wasn't till Ian had mentioned it, and I went on Google and just checked Gruffalo Trail, and there's one about 5 miles from me. It was quite a pleasant surprise. I haven't done it yet. I will do it at some point, and I will take video while I'm doing it, so I'll upload that as well. I've just managed to join the UK YouTubers in the coin community because I have a stock that could be sold if anyone is interested. You might struggle a little bit, I would guess, if you've only just joined in with the UK YouTubers. They tend to stick with people that they know and can trust. And I'm not saying you're not trustworthy in any way, but just being a newbie, it might be a little bit difficult, you know. But yeah, stick with it. I'm sure you'll get some joy out there. A mouse took a walk through the deep dark woods. Nice. It's totally over my head, Hannah. I have no idea. That's why I've been really a bit selfish. You know, I've said I wanted to see Winnie the Pooh because, oh, there are lights flashing behind me. Because we've got Winnie the Pooh is not, it's basically not far from me. You know, the poo bridge and the poo sticks and all that. So I was hoping they were going to do some of them, but as of yet, they've not done them. So anybody that's just joined in late, I said we were going to do tell you about the CJ battle. So if you haven't heard what we're doing with that, the Gruffalo is scared of the mouse like me and you on the mouse. I'm certainly scared of you, Lou. I certainly am. No, what it is, Chris, is that's actually one of the main roads for the, although I'm not dead close to the hospital or the police station, that's like one of the main roads through Tunbridge Wells. So yeah, you forever seeing flashing lights go past. Right, yeah, so that's where I was just going. So the CJ battles, to begin with, it's just going to start with, myself, Hannah, and that's the, Hannah that's in the chat here, Hans Coin Humps, Hannah Davies, and Dragon Lord Steve Fraser, who is another one that streams during the day. We've all got a £20 budget, and we're going to get allocated a one-hour time slot for eBay. Each person's time slot is different to begin with, and we have to go on there and buy anything coin related. So it could be, you know, I don't know, two Peter Rabbits, or it could be a book about coins. It could be anything like that, as long as it is coin related. Once all the prizes, they've got to film themselves doing that, to prove that it is being done on the date and the time that has been told that they've got to do it on. They can only do it on auctions. They can't do it on buy it nows. Once we've got, and I say, I don't know if Ian's still watching this, but I'm hoping it's okay with him, because I've kind of gone with this without discussing it fully with him. Once we've got the items back to us, we then send them off to Ian, and Ian will give a valuation to each person's purchases. Those purchases will then get put into a raffle on the Great British Coin Hunt website. So the idea being that you then get the chance to purchase the raffle tickets to win what we've bought. Also, obviously, we're funding the first one that we're doing ourselves, but by putting it up for a raffle, it'll become self-funding. That was the idea with it, where we were going with it. And by doing that, it will mean that we'll be able to toy about a little bit with the how much we're allocated each time that we're doing it. And what we'll do is the three of us are going to be recording it while we're on eBay doing it. We'll get those videos put together, get that up onto the site, so you'll actually see us, you know, scrolling through eBay and trying to find some deals. So you'll see all of the items first as we're buying them, and then Ian will come out with the overall winner when he gives them a valuation. And then going forward with that, again, this is just something I've just, you know, come to me on the spot. I thought, well, hang on, we're not actually doing anything for the winner. And actually, it's just a little bit of light-hearted fun and games. And hopefully, sort of, you know, I'm relatively new to buying stuff on eBay. So hopefully we'll learn a bit, and maybe some other people will learn a few bits about eBay as well. Yeah, it's, you know, just going to be a bit of fun. Once we've got it rolling a bit more, we'll invite a couple of other CJs on. Maybe from time to time, we'll open it up to some of the community. You know, let some of you guys come and join us as well for an eBay battle. Yeah, and that's the idea, just generally have a bit of fun and games with it. So, yeah, that's what the title was about. The winner, yeah, sorry, that's where I was going. The winner that I've just come up with here, the winner will then be able to choose a subject for the next one. So, for an example, they might say, right, you're only allowed to buy something coin related from 1973. So the winner gets to choose going forward how we progress with it, which will be a bit of fun. And because obviously, if you've got a specialist subject, you know, like Steve Fraser, I mean, he's way above myself and Hannah. So no doubt if he was to win, he'd pick, you know, an area that would be extremely difficult for me or Hannah. So yeah, so it'd be a bit of fun and a bit of, you know, something a little bit different, but still coin related, and we get the videos put up and yeah, just a bit of fun. The reactions I've had from it so far have been really good. So please bear with us, because somebody said something just now about they'd like to see if some videos of mishaps and that kind of thing. I'm sure we're going to get a few mishaps and that kind of thing to begin with, until we sort of iron it out, but it'll be good. Can we just catch up with you? I wanted to know what the title was, but yeah, that's what that was. I guess that I live right next to a cop shop and near the fire station. Yeah, so mine's not, the police station's not too far that way, and it's the main road for the ambulances and that again. Shut your curtains, Ryan, keep the heat in and nosy. If I've got nosy neighbours, Maria, I'll be incredibly shocked. Unless they're, you know, walking around on 30-foot stilts, I won't have anybody nosing in my windows. Officially, I am on the ground floor, but I am about 20, 30 foot up. And these curtains never get shut. I don't have the light on in the evening. I sit there and watch the stars and that kind of stuff. Are you allowed to buy American coins or UK coins? The first one is open to anything coin related. So you can buy coins from any country, any denominations, absolutely anything. The first one. Obviously, then whoever wins gets to decide going forward, you know, where they want to go with that. The winner doesn't have to wear drag. Sounds like a good idea. Good luck to all who are taking part. Thank you. So again, you know, going forward, maybe, you know, 1 month we'll throw it open and we'll let it do a battle between the mods. So the CJs will take a back seat and we let the mods do it instead. You know, so I think there's, for something really simple to start, and fingers crossed everybody jumps on board with it. You know, I mean, the raffle tickets aren't going to be expensive, you know, because we're only on a £20 budget. So obviously, if we can make our money back each time, then, you know, we'll be able to do it that way. And it'll just, you know, it'll be a bit of fun. There's so many options that we can do with it. Mod versus CJ. yeah, all this kind of thing. And that's what I say, you know, maybe from, you know, time to time we'll open it up. We'll get Amy to draw somebody's name from random and we'll open it up to, you know, some of the viewers out there that can come in and join in with us. So I think, you know, fingers crossed if it goes to plan, it'll be really good. It'll be, you know, it'll be fun. I'm not going up at Dark Chris Dyer. He's an eBay legend. But this is all part of the fun and games about it, Lorna, because although somebody might be extremely experienced on eBay, like you're saying with Chris, he's only going to be able to purchase in a 1 hour time slot with auctions that are ending in that hour. So let's say, for an example, Chris's specialist area are 50p's. Well, what if there are very, very few 50p's ending in that hour that Chris is on? He's then going to have to go and look elsewhere. Plus, whoever won it the week before gets to choose what area that they're going in to look at this time. So I think that's where it makes it a bit more interesting because obviously, you know, with me and Hannah in this first one going up against Steve Fraser. Well, Steve Fraser's an experienced seller, buyer, seller on eBay. I will admit I've managed to pick up a couple of gems on eBay recently, but they were at silly o'clock in the morning. And we're not going to do that. We're going to keep it, you know, sensible time slots. And only having that 1 hour time slot is going to make it extremely difficult for somebody that's got a specialist area to find something. So I think hopefully where Lorna's saying, you know, if you're up against somebody that's experienced, hopefully that kind of levels the playing field a little bit. And as I say, anyway, it's only, you know, it's just a light-hearted bit of fun and games, and we'll see where we can go with that. This was just an idea. It actually came from me watching some of the other lads when they went to the Mint recently. And they were all taking over each other's taking over each other's YouTube channels and that kind of thing. And I thought, obviously didn't want to go down the same road that's already been covered once. But if we come up with, you know, just a fun little game that we can play, and it just, yeah, it just kind of escalated from there. I've already had lots of other people messaging me. I just had a great idea for the Coin Jockeys. Was in the middle of writing it, and my dad phoned. Now I flipped and forgot. Yeah, that's exactly like me. All the time I do that. Hannah's just saying, Lorna, she's up against me and Steve. Honestly, Lorna, Hannah, you know, I'm as much a newbie as you are. So, as Marie says there, eBay is anybody's game at the best of times. And if you just allocating each other a 1 hour time slot on a particular day, because that's also the thing, we're not saying you can purchase anywhere Monday to Friday just between 4 and 5. It's going to be a particular day and a particular time that they've got to buy. So I think that kind of, I think that really does level it up and, it should make it a bit of fun. And, you know, hopefully, from time to time, we'll get Ian to maybe come and join in on one of them. And yeah, we'll just see where we go with it. But yeah, the reaction so far seems to be really good. I'll just give Ian a couple of minutes to see if he remembers what he was going to say for the Coin Jockeys. And all I'll say quickly before I head off, we're still looking for people to stream. I can promise you, if you want to stream on this channel, obviously trustworthy people, between 12 and 5 during the daytime, I can pretty much promise you any hours that you want. So even if it's just a 1 hour, it's just out of Jimmy Riddle and remembering. So even if it's just a 1 hour, you don't have to commit to 5 hours because 5 hours is quite a, you know, quite a slog. I can promise you any hours that you come to me with, then I will definitely be able to fit you in on those because I'm sorting out the diaries. I've got quite a few slots in the evenings to still fill. We're a bit more rigid with the evenings where we've got certain coin tubers on, my family and Bungle and these type of people who want particular slots. So another one that's a little bit tricky to fill at the moment is this slot is the 528. So yeah, so anybody out there that's you know wants to come on and showcase their coins and talk about their coins, any of that sort of stuff, get in touch and I promise you I will certainly 12 to 5 guarantee you a slot and the evenings I'll do my best to figure you out slot. Sorry, I'm just rambling, trying to wait for Ian to tell us what he's remembered. Lorna's just reminding everybody, please, please, don't forget 10 o'clock tonight. No, I don't mind, Ian. Show me. I don't know if I should be saying that, but yeah, show me. Yeah, anybody from 10 o'clock tonight, please, please tune into the Great British Coin Hunt live stream. Matt from Coins, me get a pen and paper. I've got a pen and paper here. I always have a pen and bit of paper next to me. 10 o'clock, Matt from Coins and More is going to be live streaming in drag. He lost a bet with Ian, and he has got to live stream in drag. So, I've got a pen and bit of paper. Excuse me. So that's 10 o'clock tonight. So please, please join in and share that as much as humanly possible. And let's get him absolutely loads of viewers as well. I can confirm he's taking it incredibly serious. He's got a wig and makeup and everything's being done. You've got to join in for that because this is going to be a real, real scream. Yeah, Facebook and Twitter, brilliant. Tuts at you, she's my new fellow CJ. Okay, so write down keytherapy.co.uk. Yep. www.keytherapy.co.uk. Yep, I've got that. Toxic Yushi is my new female CJ. Yeah, so only the second time ever we're going to have a female CJ at 10 o'clock tonight. Oh, so it's not going to be Matt from Coins and Us, it's going to be Martha from Coins and Us. I'm guessing you're going to want me mention key therapy 10 times in 10 streams. Yeah, absolutely. That's not a problem. I will certainly do that. And thank you again for the donation. That is brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. If we mention key therapy 10 times in 10 streams, I absolutely promise I won't just mention key therapy. I will actually share the link for key therapy in any streams that I am present on. We've just developed an income stream for the coin jockeys. Okay, I will leave that with Ian. So, mini adverts. Okie doke. I have no idea about this, so this is all new to me. So I'm sure I've probably been getting messages regarding it, but I haven't answered any of them. But yeah, I will share key therapy. £10 for a business to be mentioned 10 times. Okay. Is it 10 times in one stream or just 10 times over 10 streams? The way I understand that you've written there, so mentioned once in 10 separate streams. That's absolutely not a problem. I say I will bookmark key therapy link. No, it's the idea I said I will show you. Yeah. That's not a problem at all. I will bookmark the link and I will mention it and make sure that it gets mentioned in every stream that I'm involved in. So that's not a problem. For anybody wondering what key therapy is, this key therapy is Fran that does the psychotherapy and counselling, this kind of stuff. just reading what Ian's saying on here, any business can do this. They don't have to be jock. The jockeys are not asking for money. Yeah, we're certainly not asking people for money, but people are paying for advertising. And, oh, okay, I'm with you. That, oh, that's fantastic. So nobody is paying. It's adverts. Adverts are paying for this. So that's absolutely amazing. And so Chris is going to do the same. Lorna's going to do the same. Excuse me. Penny dropping. Don't know. So if that's okay with you, Ian, I'm going to call it a night there because I want to go and catch up with the second half of the football. But I will certainly be tuning in at 10 o'clock without a shadow of a doubt. And please, everybody else. Yeah, I'm getting the idea of it now. Yes, definitely. And it makes so much sense. Whereas previously, Ian had said donations would go to jockeys. And now this is actually adverts are paying that donation. So it's fantastic. Because I know some of the coin jockeys weren't too keen about the idea of asking for money. So this is fantastic that it all gets done via adverts, which is brilliant. You will certainly see me at 10 o'clock, yes. So that's, yeah. I'm going to leave it there for now. please get everybody you can to tune in to Matt's stream at 10 o'clock. That's the only other stream we've got going tonight. As far as I'm aware, we've got Ian on tomorrow from 12 to 5, although that might be tweaked about depending on what Jamie comes back to me and says about his hours that he would like to do. Donations feel like charity, paying for advertising. It allows everyone to feel great. Exactly. So thank you all for tuning in. I hope you like the ideas for the coin battles and that. And just again, if you've got any ideas where we can go with it, or any other ideas of things that you'd like to see, please drop us a message. And we'll see what we can sort out for it. Because essentially, without you guys, we haven't got a channel anyway, have we? So tell us what you want to see, and we'll be more than happy to try and work with it and see what we can do. Night, Javid, if you're about at 10 o'clock, I will certainly be back on, mate. I'm not missing that for anything. Hannah, is she still awake? If not, I'll have to watch it in the morning. I'll message you about 9:30, 9:45, Hannah, see if you're still awake. Sean, Alexander's curved footprint. That's other things you were talking about. It is. Okay, so thank you all for tuning in. I've got to go and watch some football now. But please hit us up if you've got any ideas with what you'd like to see. And I'll speak with Ian in the morning anyway. So thank you all for tuning in, and I'll see you all soon. Bye.